Seven things your system administrator probably won't tell you. Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. Besides doing Ask Leo and a number of other things on my own, I do administer systems for a few selected friends and acquaintances. But in doing so, it's important to understand just how much you are trusting your system administrator when that's you. So what do I mean by a system administrator? Well, honestly, anybody that can set things up and do things for you. In my world, that typically means administering a server on which a website exists and on which email is processed. It's also possible that you could consider someone who set up your PC as your system administrator. Or it could be someone who has simply registered a domain or help you configure your email. They too are a form of system administrator. The interesting thing here is that what a lot of people don't realize, like I said, is just how much power they're giving to their system administrator and how much trust is really involved. And most system administrators, yeah, they might answer. They might tell you if pressed, but rarely do they proactively tell you all of the control that they really, really do have. What I want to do in this video is run through seven specific things that I think system administrators really ought to be telling you. And if you're one of the sites or services that I administer personally, consider this me telling you. Number one, I can read your email. Seriously, when someone sets up email, especially on a server, they have access to the email as it flows through that server. And as I've covered in previous articles, email by itself is not secure. If you are not proactively encrypting the email you send, it's going out in plain text. And anybody with access to the server that is processing your email can see it. Number two, I can impersonate you. With that email access, I can actually do things like send email that doesn't just look like it came from you. It actually did come from you because it came from your account. Now, that can be a very important aspect of being a system administrator. I know that I've used this in the past to recover accounts that would have otherwise been lost. But that's because I'm a good guy. I'm using my powers for good. It is a power that can be used for evil if your system administrator decides that they want to go that route. Number three, I can copy all your files. Again, whatever is on your server, whatever is on the machine you have given your system administrator access to, they have access to it. Now, they may be able to look at your files, but it's important to understand that if you can look at a file, you can copy a file. Now, one of the things that I do for the systems that I administer is I back them up. What is a backup but a copy of everything on the server? So that means that for those other folks for whom I'm administering their website, their email, their whatever, yeah, I've got backup copies on my machines, here at home, in my basement, and possibly somewhere in my cloud storage. Number four, I can hijack your domain. This is one that probably makes people a little bit nervous. If you don't know how to register a domain and set it up, yes, you will be reaching out for help to do that. It's a logical thing to do. But understand then that the person who is helping you has a level of control that perhaps sometimes later they could actually transfer your domain without your knowledge or your consent. Again, it's a matter of trust, but it is also something that is very important in order for them to be able to help you do your job. I can shut you down. This is the scary one to me. It's something that I don't joke about, but I do. And that is, I've occasionally in extreme jest said, don't piss me off because I could take your business down. Now, obviously, I never, ever would. I'm not that kind of person. But If your system administrator was someone who could go down that path, then absolutely the amount of control that you've given your system administrator could be enough to take you off the web, take your website down, shut down your email, any number of different things that actually, like I said, sound really, really scary. There's at least one story that I heard some years ago where a system administrator wasn't getting paid by the person whose website he was administering. So, on that person's website, he put his complaint. Now, that's benign, right? In a sense that the website is still there, it's still owned by that person, but it now has some disparaging remarks about that person in order to force that person to pay his bills. I'm not even going to say whether that's ethical. I don't think it is. But the bottom line here is that that kind of power, that kind of reaction in a system administrator is absolutely possible and can be devastating if they go rogue. Number six, what a lot of system administrators don't realize is that, well, yeah, I'm at risk too. And I say that because let's say I did go rogue. Let's say I did do something to your website. I defaced your website in a moment of anger or reaction. Well, there are probably legal things that you, as the website owner, could do to cause me a lot of grief. So a good system administrator will understand that there are ramifications for any negative actions that he may or may not take. And the definition of negative action requires kind of an agreement, right? If you, as the site owner or as the service owner, and he, as the system administrator, don't agree on what's right and wrong, then yeah, you could both cause each other a lot of grief. And that is, in fact, bidirectional. The people for whom I am administering systems could cause me a lot of grief if, for whatever reason, they decided that they didn't like what I was doing. Number seven, again, this is something that I think a lot of people don't understand, especially system administrators, but honestly, the people that hire them. I can be your partner. In other words, I have a lot of knowledge about your systems and your setup, and hopefully some knowledge about your business or what it is you're attempting to do. By partnering with your system administrator, you can take advantage of options, business resources, or cost-cutting measures, or resource improvements that actually would benefit you or your business or whatever it is you're setting up. Find a system administrator that you trust, and then do what you can to partner with them. If they're not willing to partner, maybe it's time to find a different system administrator, or maybe that's just not what they consider to be their job. But the point is, a really good system administrator is worthy of your trust and is someone that you can work with to improve your business. Now, I do have to make kind of a caveat here at the end, because I'm not saying that system administrators are evil. They are not. They're critical. They're an important part of keeping the internet as we know it working. But it's important for you, as someone who might engage the services of a system administrator, to understand just how much control you're giving them and how much trust you need to have in their abilities and, honestly, their ethics. I hope that's helpful. I hope that helps you find someone that can do the job for you in a way that makes you feel comfortable. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5065. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.